An overnight shooting in Des Moines has left a man in the hospital.
Police say 21-year-old Rashante Jewett was shot twice near the Come and Go store at 22nd and University. It's all unfolded after 1 o'clock this morning. He's still in the hospital tonight, but police say he should recover. Police did not have any suspects, they say, in part because the group of people that surrounded Tate Jewett when rescue crews arrived refused to cooperate. Mark Tauschek is live in the newsroom now with more on the effort to get young people to understand why it's so important to work with police. Mark?
Well, I spoke with an outreach group tonight who is going to be spending the next 4 Friday nights driving around Des Moines, making contact with youth who are out late at night. This new group called Ride Out, a joint effort between Creative Visions and Mothers Against Violence, knows there are plenty of young people who want to do the right thing and help police, but don't because of peer pressure.
We're looking at it from our world as if that looks ridiculous. Why would you be a victim of a crime and not use the authorities? It's sad because it's almost like they cheapen the value of their own lives by they deciding that the same things that's been put in place with society to protect you, you won't even use it.
Now, the short explanation is the outreach volunteers are going to be driving around town late at night in vans, going to where they know young people are going to be hanging out. They'll get out and approach them, handing out cards with phone numbers they can call if they have information on a crime, want to talk about a situation they're in, or just want a safe place to go to get off the street. Ride Out volunteers say they aren't going to be lecturing the kids. They just want young folks out late at night to know they have options if they want to make better decisions without being labeled a sellout or a snitch.
They might not want to say it, you know, out there in the crowd, and maybe they'll go home and think about it and decide they want to talk to one of us and call us or text us, you know, in the safety of their own home where they're not around their friends, around that peer pressure.
The Ride Out group says the next step will be going around to neighborhoods approaching parents as well. They'll reassess after Labor Day whether they'll continue their Friday night outreach efforts through the fall or just wait to start up again next spring when school lets out. Kevin?
Thanks, Mark.